With the car now animated, you are ready to use the Snapshot tool to create clones. If you have not saved your file earlier, you can catch up by using the file car-sim-animated.max you downloaded for this tutorial. Before you use Snapshot, consider the car's motion. As was the case with the fighter plane, the car's speed is changing. Only it is worse in this case as it comes to a complete stop before the end of the animation. Also, it is traveling much faster between frames 0 and 20 than it is between frames 20 and 100 as it slows down after impact. Using Snapshot as you did before might prove problematic because of this. To test it out, select the car and go to Tools, Snapshot. Set it to Range Mode, encompassing the whole animation from 0 to 100, and set the number of mesh copies to about 12. Click OK. Now what happens? You have fewer clones where the car is traveling fast, and bunched up duplicates as it slows down to a stop. You actually have about 4 clones sharing the same spot where the car comes to a stop. In a situation like this, it is often best to use the Snapshot tool in stages. You run it once to create the clones when the car is fast, then a second time when the car is slowing down. Press Ctrl-Z to undo the creation of duplicates. With the car selected, go to the Snapshot dialog once more. This time, specify 6 duplicates only between frames 0 and 20. This is when the car is traveling fast. Click OK to create the clones. With the original car still selected, go back to the Snapshot tool and specify 6 copies again, only this time ranging between frames 25 and 65. This is when the car slows down after impact and a fraction before coming to a complete stop. Click OK to create the clones and exit the dialog. Play back the animation. This looks good, but you still need to make the clones more transparent. Select all the clones from the Select from Scene dialog, H on the keyboard. Go to the Slate Material Editor. The material for the car is already displayed. It's a multi-sub-object material to make sure it accounts for the steel and glass parts of the car. You need to copy it and make the copy more transparent. Select all 4 nodes that define the car material, and then shift and drag to make a copy. Click in a gray area of the material editor to deselect all the nodes. Go into the copy's submaterials parameters and make them more transparent. 15% opacity for the steel and 12% opacity for the glass. If you want to, enable Show Shaded Material in Viewport on the steel material. Select the top node and apply a new material to the selection. Exit the material editor and deselect all objects in the scene. In the next movie, you animate the visibility of the clones so that they appear only after the car matches their position.